Welcome back, guys. In this new video, we get to look at the effusion rates of different gases. Now, tied with effusion is basically the concept of velocity and speed. Remember, we use root mean square equations when we're dealing with the speed of one gas. We use effusion when we're comparing the speeds or velocities of multiple gases. That's when we use this concept. Here we're going to say Graham's law states that the rate of effusion of a gas is inversely proportional to the square root of its molar mass. What this is really saying is that the speed or rate at which a gas moves, so effusion is just seen as speed. So the speed of a gas is the opposite of its weight. What that means is, if my speed is high, it's because the mass of my gas is low. So basically, the less you weigh as a gas, the faster you move. That's what effusion is trying to explain. And effusion looks and compares multiple gases to each other. Gas A moves faster than gas B. Why is that? Well, gas A must weigh less. That's why it's moving faster. Now, we're going to say, when we're comparing the rates of two gases, we use this form of Graham's law of effusion. Now, pay close attention. So basically, we're going to say the rate of gas 1 is equal to its rate divided by the rate of gas 2. And we're going to say that equals the square root. And look, if gas 1's rate is on the top, then its mass is on the bottom. Because remember, Graham's law says that rate and mass are inversely proportional. They're on opposite levels. And here, if the rate of gas 2 is on the bottom, then its mass is on the top. We're going to have to take this approach to answer some of these questions.